TNT Stadium. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Baltimore Ravens and the Dallas Cowboys. On the return, the old reliable Devin Hester, the veteran. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Throwing here on first down, Flacco. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Flacco here on second down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. Third down, Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. Surveying the field, underneath to Allen. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. You know, last week, Charles, I asked you about this Dallas defense. What do you make of an 8-1, so much hype about the offense? Let's turn it defensive.
And they're a defense that really doesn't care about who gets the credit. And I know that's one of those great cliches, but they don't have that superstar that everyone just latches onto, except maybe Sean Lee, their linebacker, who I think is a marvelous player all over the field when he's out there. But also, in this game, it was a return to the Pittsburgh area where he grew up and grew up a Steelers fan. Had to be very sweet for him to take away a victory.
Exactly. Get to 8-1. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. There comes the 11 on offense back onto the field for Dallas. And Ezekiel Elliott effusively praised his O-line after their Week 10 win, said, bottom line, I'm running behind the best O-line in the league.
And he's right. And they invested in this offensive line. Travis Frederick, the center, is a Pro Bowl guy, a first-round pick. Tyron Smith, left tackle, first-round pick. Zach Martin, right guard, first-round pick. No accident, they're all Pro Bowlers and all Pro players. But at left guard, Ronald Leary is playing awfully well, filling in for Lyle Collins, who many thought would be a first-round pick, and Doug Free is steady Eddie at right tackle. This unit is terrific, and when we talk about MVPs, these guys won't win it, but we should mention them.
And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on 2nd and 11. Another carry for the rookie Elliott. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Well, if you didn't know Ezekiel Elliott when he was at Ohio State, you know him by now in Week 10 in the NFL.
And not only do you know him, you have to talk about him being a potential MVP. And I know that sounds crazy, a rookie running back. But boy, the way he has played and the numbers he's putting up, in addition to expanding his game, he had 2 catches in the last one for what, 95 yards, a touchdown. One of them being 83 yards on a touchdown catch. He's doing everything for them, carrying the load. I think he sets the tone in a big way for the Dallas offense.
Yeah, 2 more on the ground against the Steelers in the end zone, including the game winner.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that 3rd down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a 1st down.
3rd time's a charm, right? 2 incompletions. Had to have it on 3rd, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
A 1st down carry by Elliott. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off. I can't believe they even let you play.
Let's go! 1, 9, 10!
Now Prescott. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
That was not a completion that resulted in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
Tight right, alert, alert. 3 out, 3 out.
Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third down.
Could be a blitzer.
Going right side, he has Winton. A gain of 7, and they pick up the first.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Now back to the ground with Elliott. Oh, nice move. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Give them 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn them a fresh set of downs. So good for the Buckeyes last year, and he's taken that from the college game, showing some glimpses of it here in the NFL.
How about his last season with Ohio State? Over 1,800 yards, only one game where he didn't get over 100. Remember, he demanded the ball from then on out. I think they listened to him, and they were smart to do so.
And now they're giving it to him here on the next level. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Here's Prescott. His throw incomplete. Cole Beasley, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down. Second down, Elliott. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got time in the pocket. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
On now is Dan Bailey, 5 of 6 from 50-plus last year. It'll be spotted on the right hash, a 52-yard attempt. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the Cowboys are going to jump out to a 3-0 lead. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Now, after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. Moore now on the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Ravens' offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, if they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he's brought down after a good game. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, they know how to protect the pass, but sometimes cornerbacks, they can also stop the run, can't they?
Is that what we call a complete corner? Yeah, because we're so used to these guys just being defenders in the pass game. How about the guys who can come up and make the tackles? That's what we just saw there for no gain, too.
Flacco from midfield. He's going to sling this deep downfield. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Third down, Flacco from the gun. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they've got to make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
We really didn't have any doubt that he was going to be one of the top-rated rookies coming into the league, especially as a runner. And he's given us no reason to change our minds. That's a big-time run, and the production that he showed us in college is translating very well into the National Football League.
Here we go!
They keep on the ground with Elliott, and he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And that's incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time. And now it's third down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on third and 14. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Complete to Jason Witten. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. Size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
They'll look to throw now on first down. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. Big game for Dez against the Steelers. A touchdown, 116 yards. And Jason Garrett presented a very emotional Dez Bryant with a game ball afterwards because his father passed away the day before.
And that's the type of story that hits all of us, because when you're talking about losing a parent, I mean, there's just nothing worse in your mind that you have to go through. And Dez did that. Played the game. You know he played it in his honor and played it awfully well. A big touchdown catch from Dak Prescott. Dez Bryant is a big key to their passing game as they progress towards the playoffs.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Prescott. He hits Beasley right side. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. They'll come out in the pistol. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. It's caught on the right side, Williams. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Second down now after the pass completion.
Let's go! Fan 38! Fan 38!
Here's Prescott. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
Game as he looks to throw. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. Terrence Williams, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Kick it away after the touchdown. Now Hester will get a shot. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team. Right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense looking at a 2nd and 8. On the ground, it's West again. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. The offense in that middle ground here on 3rd down, 3rd and 5. Fake to Allen. Here's Flacco. Then he finds his man, Kamar Aiken. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Throwing here on first down, Flacco. Smith catches left side. A gain of 32 that time. So we have come to halftime here in Dallas with the Cowboys out in front as we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
3 yards to go on second down. They go to Elliott again. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game. And with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Elliott, and he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Give him 4 on the ground there. They're now left with 3rd and 6.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. And that's caught by Beasley. And he's brought down after a good game. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Lawrence Guy in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. They get 2 yards back, but they're going to need a lot more than that here on third down.
Tough day. tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down.
Here we go. One, two.
Now Prescott. And Beasley with it over the middle. And he's brought down after a good game. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And now a first down following that long gain. One man in the backfield, Elliott. And he'll get it up the middle. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackle was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Back now in Arlington, it's the Cowboys with a football. They'll be looking to tack onto their lead as we get set for the fourth.
Strong left, strong left. Here we go, D, get off the field. Come on, let's go. White, 90.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. His throw is going to be incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver, third down here. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Now the fifth-year man, this is Lance Dunbar. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. Flags come in. I think one of the Ravens got going a little early. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. Flacco setting up the screen for West, and he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It'll be a gain of 11, and it'll make it second down. A good start there on first down. They've got to have this drive.
No doubt about it. Down a couple of scores, they have to find a way to put it in the end zone. Chunk plays, explosive plays, that will be the key to this drive.
Flacco here on second down. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Mike Wallace, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Third down, Flacco from the gun. To Allen on the dump off. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. They'll run for it with West. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Call it a gain of 3. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
I tell you, on 4th and 1, when you're way back on your side of the field, I thought this might just be an attempt to draw him off and get the first down that way. But they were going for it the whole time, and they wind up getting it.
They look to throw on 1st and 10 with Flacco. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Second and 10, Flacco once more. Smith catches left side. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the 2-minute warning. Now flags come in. I think one of the Ravens got going a little early. He's got the hookup. It's complete. The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3. Flacco to throw here on 3rd down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the linebacker, Sean Lee. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And last time they were able to churn some clock, they got the field goal, added onto their lead. But that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Again, it's Elliott. And now the Ravens are going to take another timeout. That'll be their 2nd, so 1 more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Still 9 yards to go on 3rd down. They'll run it now. Here's Dunbar. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Out now comes the Cowboys punter, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. He'll try and keep this away from Hester as this is going toward the sideline. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive, then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
And hauled in by Pitta. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it a second down. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Second down, Flacco now. Incomplete. Kamar Aiken, the intended receiver, and it's third and short. Defense has to stand tall here, third and one. Third and just one, it's Flacco. Now a desperation, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Brandon Carr, and his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field, and they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
Then they got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Victory very much in sight now as they'll take a knee. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is, and what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them, going along with those zeros in the time column, too.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Cowboys.